Hi, I'm Tony. Welcome to Sports Bike Shop's video about the all new Shoei NXR 2 helmet. Shoei's NXR 2 helmet is the latest in a long line of very popular sports helmets by Shoei that goes way back to the XR 700 and probably even beyond that. We're making this video with the first full production sample of the Shoei NXR 2 that you see here, and as we record this, it's still going to be another 4 or 5 months before this helmet is available for sale. I've had this NXR 2 for the last 3 days and I've covered around 300 road miles in it to try and give you the best possible insight on what to expect from Shoei's latest new model. It's an evolution of the existing NXR rather than a rip it up and start again job, but that's no bad thing really, as the NXR is an excellent and very popular helmet already. The big and most noticeable changes are in the visor and the ventilation, but there's one major change that will probably be imperceptible to most of us. This helmet meets a new safety standard that's going to supersede our existing one here in Europe. This is the first helmet we've tested that meets ECE 2206. That new standard will be phased in over the next few years to replace 2205, which has been in place here since the year 2000. The NXR 2 seems very slightly bigger than the outgoing NXR, which is most likely because extra protection material is needed to meet the new test standards. Weight is also increased by a very small margin. This medium-sized NXR 2 weighs in on our scales at 1,423 grams, which is around 110 grams more than the outgoing helmet in the same size. So those are the bits you probably won't notice. Let's have a dig into some of the bits that you probably will. The CWR F2 visor is all new, and it's the first of the recent Shoei's with a central lifting tab. It lifts by pushing this bit here to release the tab and then lifting that from there. The new mounting base plates for that visor mean it can be opened slightly to allow in a small amount of air without there being so much coming in through there that your eyes start to water, and that's a clear improvement over the current NXR. The visor also now has what Shoei call vortex generators on each side. They're these little extrusions around the side here, and they're designed to smooth out the flow of air and make the ride quieter. Those are taken from the existing design of Shoei's X-Spirit 3 race helmet. The new base plate, it's all new, also has a new easier way of tightening or relaxing the seal between the visor and the aperture trim. This lever here, just flicking it there, alters the position of this base plate, and it alters the seal between the visor and this trim around here. The visor is protected against misting by a Pinlock Max Vision insert, and it's a Pinlock Evo, which is their highest grade of insert in terms of moisture protection, supplied in the box with the helmet. The Pinlock also gets a helping hand in terms of clearing mist from a new chin vent, which operates on this slide switch here, and it brings cooling air through the top of the chin bar and to the interior of the helmet. The vent on the original NXR is excellent, and so is this one. Opening that feels like turning on a cold air dryer that really brings in a lot of air. It works in tandem with three vents that sit on the top of the helmet, which are also brilliant at pulling in cooling air. Shoei's work in the wind tunnel has especially paid off with the vent at the front and the center here. It pulls in a huge amount of air. I first wore this helmet on a really chilly April day, and I knew all about the volume of air that was coming in. The two sliders either side of it are really good too, but the effect from these isn't quite as noticeable as it is from that one at the front and the center there, which is really a big upgrade over the existing NXR for two reasons. It pulls in more air, and it's also easier to use. The vent on the current NXR has a smaller switch that's harder to locate, and it's also harder to operate, especially while wearing gloves. Once the air comes inside the helmet, it moves through channels in the impact liner, and then it exits through these extractors in the rear spoiler here. Those are permanently open, which is another change over the outgoing NXR, as that helmet has switches to allow you to close the exhaust vents. So externally, those are the main changes for the NXR 2. The shell is very slightly different in profile to the existing NXR, mostly around the spoiler area, but it's still clearly derived from that original NXR. The shell is made from the same advanced integrated matrix, which is a series of different fibers that balance lightweight and impact protection. There are four shell sizes for this helmet. The smallest covers lid sizes from double extra small through to small. Medium and large each have their own shell size, and the fourth and biggest shell size covers XL and double XL. Internally, there are some minor changes from the NXR. The removable lining has a soft brushed material here where it drags over your skin when you're putting the helmet on or when you're taking it off. And then it has sections of material that are better at managing moisture where you're most likely to sweat, such as just above the eyebrows here. So while we're talking about the interior, this helmet isn't prepared for a dedicated Senna intercom like many other Shoei models are. That's something Shoei say they've avoided with this helmet because it's a sporty helmet rather than a sports touring helmet. You can fit a universal intercom to this, and there are recesses in the EPS to make that more comfortable. But as I said, there's not a dedicated Senna unit by Shoei. The cheek pads have emergency release pull tabs. So if it's necessary, they can be taken off while the rider's still wearing the lid, which makes helmet removal easier at the scene of an accident. Shoei are also one of the manufacturers where you're able to swap the cheek pads inside for thinner or thicker ones to alter the fit slightly. If you're buying the lid from us, you can get in touch with our customer support team and they'll fix that up for you if that's something you need. Also on that interior, as you'd expect from a sporty road lid, it's a double D-ring strap fastener, and these covers that protect your skin from being sort of made sore by the strap, they can be removed and washed as well. And the helmet comes with an optional chin curtain just here and a breath guard there. So let's talk about safety approvals. As I said earlier, the NXR2 meets the new Euro 2206 standard as a full face road helmet. We're making this video before this helmet's even made it into the hands of the ACU, which is the UK's racing governing body. But you'll be able to knock me over with a robin's feather if this lid doesn't gain approval from them for use in racing and on track days. Perhaps, obviously, it's still too early for the NXR2 to have been rated under the UK government's Sharp Impact Testing Programme. So, after those 300 miles or so that I've worn this helmet for, you might want to know what I think of it. It's typically Shoei. The build quality is a cut above the norm, and this helmet has genuinely, seriously impressed me over the few days that I've had it. The fact there's no sun visor means this is a sporty road lid, and I think it'd be great for people who don't mind swapping visors to suit the light conditions, or people who only ride in the daytime and are happy to leave a tinted visor on it all the time. That new venting system is really good. It's an upgrade on the NXRs, which was good anyway, and the field of vision through that visor is really good too. I didn't find it noisy. I tested this helmet while riding a GSXR 1000R, but these things are always a bit subjective, and just because I found it quiet doesn't mean that everyone will. The Shoei NXR2 is going to be available in late summer 2021. The launch price for this helmet will be £429.99 for basic plain colours like this white helmet, it'll be £449.99 for metallic plain paint options, and then it'll be £539.99 for the graphic options. I hope that tells you everything you wanted to know about the new Shoei NXR2 helmet. But if there is anything you'd like to ask or to add, then please pop a comment below. Thanks for watching.